Hi, I'm Marcy Sutton Todd. I'm a senior developer at Principal Studios. I created this course on web app accessibility so that developers could contribute to more accessible websites and web apps. I found that without this care and attention, that the web is totally inaccessible to people with disabilities. In this course, we'll cover screen readers and assistive technologies, accessibility debugging, accessible HTML, ARIA, or accessible rich internet applications, focus management for the keyboard, and visual considerations. With this knowledge, I hope you can go and help create a more accessible web for everyone.
We've got some really important reasons to overcome what I'm calling access debt. So we have design debt, we have technical debt, we have access debt. Stuff in our code base, I mean, the design and development are so overlapping in what create these problems that we've got a unique type of debt that is accessibility debt. And the reasons that we need to overcome it, the most basic reason, you know, thinking back to the Capitol crawl and the disability rights and activism, is it's a civil right to have access. And that should be enough. That really should be enough of a reason. It's something we've been fighting for decades, and we really should honor that. It's the right thing to do. Sometimes that is just lost in translation. And so depending on who you need to convince, like maybe you have some other stakeholders or coworkers or people who just don't care for whatever reason. There's other reasons that we can kind of pull out as a carrot. You know, we have the carrot and the stick way of communicating our reasons why this is important. The legal issues are a big stick to use. People, depending on what country you're in, you have different laws that make accessibility a requirement, especially in certain sectors, like anything procured by the federal government, education. There's lots of different areas where the legal side applies. It's not my favorite aspect of it, but it is part of it. Sometimes pride in your craft is the way to get through to people, like being pragmatic about quality in your software. And sometimes that can be the angle to get someone sort of selfishly to care about it, is that you can make it easier to test, you could make it more robust, being able to make your application respond to different user inputs that you haven't even thought of yet. It's just more robust software. And it's mostly, the web is mostly accessible by default. We just have to try not to mess it up. And then there's business cases. Like if you have to convince business stakeholders, maybe there's a way to persuade these folks about having a larger customer reach, a risk of losing out on business. And so, yeah, there's all of these different levers that we can kind of pull to make the case for accessibility, which I do have to say, though, like as a single interactive developer, UI developer, full stack, whatever your role is, this is a little bit, it's a bit much to try and carry this weight on your back all the time, to be like, I'm doing this work and trying to convince everyone around me to do it. So I want you to give yourself some grace. That's why accessibility can be sort of draining, but I want to invigorate you to find the things that you can control and that you can change, and we want to make progress. That's why celebrating those wins is important. We want to balance all of this with getting our job done and upholding quality among all the other things that we have to think about. So let's open this up with VoiceOver. So I'm on a Mac computer. So to open up VoiceOver, I will hold my function key first. If you have a desktop keyboard, you won't have a function key, but on a Mac laptop, it would be function command F5.
Navigation, visited, link, heading level 1, web accessibility, V3, current item, visited, link, all topics, search documentation, search text field, blank, command K, link.
So at any time, a little bit of a navigation tip when you're running VoiceOver is that to get it to stop reading, you can press the control key. So especially when you're talking at the same time, it can be pretty helpful. You can also click on the page to kind of get to an area that you want to test so you don't have to navigate through the whole thing. Because I want us to focus on this book a trip form, whereas there are a ton of other elements on the page for the slide materials. So I'm going to click closer to this form. I could even click
level
on
level 1 link permalink for this section main. You okay. Are currently on a link.
So my first key that I often use is the tab key. Let's hit tab, see what happens.
One way, unchecked, checkbox, book a flight, group, checked, one way, checkbox.
So if I hit the space bar, I can toggle that element. Depending on what element it is, what type of role and keyboard accessibility it has.
Use miles, unchecked, checkbox.
And I can go through these.
Use miles, checkbox.
And so the tab key, however, is not the only way to navigate. So from that cheat sheet I referenced myself this morning to remember, there are the voiceover keys, which are control and option. And if I do control, option, right arrow, I can go to the next item, whatever that item happens to be.
From. You are currently on a text element. From. Edit text. You are to. You are currently on a text element. Edit text. Blank. Departure date. You are currently on a departure date. Edit text. You are currently on an edit text. To enter this date field, press control, option, shift, down arrow. 03. You are currently on a stepper, inside, -02/2024. You, end of text.
So I can use arrow keys, I can type, I can do all kinds of things in here. So depending on what type of element it is, so if it's a text field, if it's an image, if it's a heading, it will announce that type of element. So that's relevant. If things are labeled or not, that will also be part of it. So like this form field.
From. You are currently on a text element.
Is labeled. If I go down further to images.
Edit text. 0 1 0.
I'm going to hit tab to get 0, there 12, quickly.
Submit. Level 1. Visited. Link. Other assistive technologies. The what character. Ooh. Palette. Close by. Chrome. Screens. Make your escape. A dirt path next to a small lake. With fall colors of red, yellow, and green. The sky is blue with wispy high clouds. Image. You are currently
so
on
the
image.
So there's some alt text. There is a full screen image state that we're setting on and off when you click on that image. So the image is, first of all, it's a div with an on click. Let's make that a button. Let's give it an ARIA label. Open image in full screen. Because the alt attribute would supply text to that button, but it would just be the alt attribute from the image, and that wouldn't really say what this action's gonna do. So clicking on this button in this iteration will open it in a full screen layer. So this layer down here, as which is just a regular old div, it's got some positioning on it. It has a close button that is another div with a click event on it. I think we could just cut our losses and try a built pre-built component. And we have some pre-built components in here using Chakra UI. And for React, I think they have view versions and maybe some other options as well. It's pretty solid. So I would definitely recommend checking it out if you're in this, you know, part of web development. So let's pull in, I'm gonna open up our Modal Chakra UI. So for this example, we will grab these components. We already have Chakra UI React in our project, so it's pretty easy to grab these. We have an image component, so I'm going to add to it. And for our modal, we're gonna go pull in some of these components. So I've got the imports. Let's grab some of this content as well. They have multiple overlays here. I want to get the basic usage. So we already have a button to open it. We will grab this modal. We even have the state to open and close it. We just want the markup from this component. So down here in JSX, I will leave our full screen image state to render this. And instead of modal is open, I will say, set full screen image, or let's see, what do I want to call it? Yes, so what did I add here before? Actually, on close, I will say, what did I have before? So we had close full screen, so I have a full screen image and close full screen. Get back here. Close full screen. So since I'm not passing any arguments, I can just reference this callback function. For this one, I'm going to say, I'm going to take full screen image, and it will be a string, I believe. And so I can turn it into a truthy-falsy variable just by putting a double exclamation point in front of it. So that will hinge off of that state that I'm already managing. And we can go up here to see that. Full screen image is being managed with use state. Okay, so we are not going to use a modal footer. The modal body will be our image. So I'm going to grab the image. I think it's just scaled down in the smaller size. So if I open it up with the same asset, it'll just have the display to show it bigger. But I think if you had different size image assets, you would show a bigger one in the full screen gallery, right? So our modal title, this one, the design does not have a title showing. Titles are pretty important for modals. So I think in this case, I might just include one, and then I would talk with my team, like, how are we going to handle this? The design doesn't have a title on it, but we have to include one. I could investigate adding a screen reader only class to this or something to keep it there, but not show it visually. But for now, I'm going to put the alt attribute, or maybe the product name. Only one of those. Okay, so we have a modal. Let's see what it looks like. Hey, there it is. Our style looks a little weird, but it's already there. It opened up. It's in the full context of the window. And so I can probably control that with some relative positioning. But that was like the easiest modal implementation I've ever done. And we can take advantage of some of these libraries now. Like, it didn't used to be that you could grab a modal off the shelf and have any hope that it would be accessible. But, like, this is awesome.